state media drifting in here tonight. Always good to see our good buddy Ben Talbot and Tommy Riley, Bird's Eye Sports, here tonight. They'll be racking up some highlights for folks to watch online, that's for certain. But these two teams, a year ago, each split, as we were talking about, Steve, Holy Cross won big on their home floor, which was a surprise to everybody, a game we did. And then Holy Cross comes over across town, and Crosby defeats them in a tight matchup here
at the
Palace.
About a six-point win at home for the Bulldogs last year, while Holy Cross at home won by about 18, as really dominated the game on their court.
Well, both teams, yeah, go ahead.
I was going to say, you don't see the Bulldogs lose too many games here at the Palace.
And tonight we will have three officials, Mike Scanlon, Gary Rispoli, and Bill Murphy. So we'll have another three officials in this game tonight. We'll see how they call it. See if it was as tight as last week's game down at the Alumni Hall was being called by that officiating crew, or whether they open it up a little bit and let the guys play ball here at the Palace. A couple of minutes still to go before we start this basketball game. And, Steve, as we take a look around the Naugatuck Valley League, it's a very competitive league this year.
It has been a very competitive league thus far this season. Predominantly dominated by the city schools, as you would expect, but can't forget the boys from up north in Torrington, off to another great start. 3-1, or 4-1 overall record.
Yep.
Their only loss to Sacred Heart last week, as the Hearts defeated both Torrington and Crosby by 16 points each.
Well, pretty good, pretty impressive run last weekend. They also throw in a Hearts victory, a 20-point victory over Naugatuck. So the Hearts really quite impressive so far here in the first half of the season, and sit atop of the NVL along with this Holy Cross squad, and that is on deck.
That game is coming up. I believe it's a week from now.
1 week from, or is
from
it Tuesday?
Last night.
Holy Cross and Crosby. It's on our schedule.
Holy Cross and Sacred Heart.
Yep. So Holy Cross, Sacred Heart coming up. And
January 16th, in 2 weeks.
In 2 weeks.
It's a Tuesday night game, January 6th, next Tuesday.
So it's this Tuesday. Allie and Dave will have that call. Holy Cross has just come over to shake hands, give a hug to Carm Cocciolo, the athletic director down at Sacred Heart. And once again, our prayers with Carm as he's recovering from some physical ailment. On, we wish him all the best. It's good to see the big man back around the gyms, as we mentioned a week ago down at Alumni Hall. Both teams getting ready to go through their introductions and get ready to play this basketball game here tonight as the fans continue to file in. We are close to capacity here at the Palace tonight. It is a pretty good gym.
And I think, if you're not in the area, you better hurry up and get here, because they may end up selling this place out. It's not sold out yet, but it could very well be. Just going through the final pregame, as we're going to have our player introductions coming up, and just going over some of the scoring averages. We mentioned for the Crusaders, Zimmerman leading with a 20-point game per game average. Kyle Murphy averages nearly 16 points, Ryan Cole 15, and Rob Minetti close to 14 points a game. Bulldogs no slouches either, as a team averaging 87 points per game, led by Anthony Ireland with 25, his lowest output of the season, 22 points against Ansonia earlier this week. Also in double figures, Vasquez 12.5, Cortez 11, and Mike Manning with 10.
We'll take a two-minute timeout, and when we come back, we'll have the start of tonight's game. You're listening to NVL Basketball on 1320 WATR.
Oh, say, can you see by the Check.
Three Palace, Bob Sagendorf, Steve Gessick, and Arthur Gordon Woods Jr. here tonight bringing you all kinds of basketball action with Holy Cross and Crosby getting set to get underway. Starting lineups tonight for the Holy Cross Crusaders: Taquan Zimmerman, Kyle Murphy, Ryan Kolb, Rob Minetti, and Trevor Platt. For the Crosby Bulldogs, no surprises here: Steve Gessick, Anthony Ireland, Mike Manning, Julio Vasquez, Ricky Cortez, Malik Gray.
No surprises at all. We mentioned the scoring off the starters, which is fairly even. This game could come down to which team gets more points off the bench tonight.
So we get ready for some basketball. We'll go through all the final lineups here for starting lineups for the Crosby Bulldogs now. Here's Anthony Ireland, 25 points a game. Anthony's had a good first part of the season. There's Julio Vasquez coming in. Malik Gray at center.
At forward, number 22,
Ricky Cortez, who's had a fine defensive season so far. And the last forward, here's Mike Manning. All right, so the starting lineups are there. Both teams getting ready as Crosby gets into their little huddle. Jumping up and down at right in the middle of the center of the floor.
Yeah, we mentioned a lot about the players, but this game is also about the coaching.
Yeah.
As you have two of the finest in the state, Nick Augelli in his 29th season at Generali and his 25th overall, 20th here at Holy Cross. Combined total 927 wins between the two men coaching these two teams.
Not too bad, huh?
Not too bad. And, of course, they probably faced each other close to 50 times over their careers.
You know, Gordy had some great research about the streaks in this series. Holy Cross leads it overall 22-11. But there was a period of time there. What Holy Cross went 19 of 20?
They had a 10-game winning streak. Crosby won one and then won another nine. 19 out of 20 games. And this is since 1992 that Gordy's records are. And 22-11 overall lead. 19 of those 22 in that one stretch.
Well, the gym is ready, that's for certain. Folks all on the opposite side of the Crosby cheering section, getting themselves all wound up. Holy Cross cheering section over by their bench. Always well represented student body by Holy Cross.
Whether it's boys or girls basketball, yep, they do turn out and support their teams.
All right, here we go. It'll be Manning in the center jump with Cole, controlled by the Crusaders. Right away, Zimmerman wants to bring it to the rack and puts it home. Cody Zimmerman, Holy Cross, right off the opening tap, takes a 2-0 lead. Crosby quickly into the forecourt. Julio Vasquez comes to Ireland, covered by Minetti. Cortez, Ireland, Vasquez. Corner. Three ball, no good by Manning. Battled for and retained by Crosby. Out of bounds, and Cortez will inbound.
Cortez with possession there. Rob Minetti knocking the ball out of his hands, out of bounds. Ball stays with the Bulldogs.
Cortez gets the inbound to Vasquez, way out by the midline. Now left side to Ireland. Coming baseline, comes Cortez, goes up and down. Goes up and down, does not release the ball in time. His first turnover of the night by the Crosby Bulldogs. And leading 2-0 with 30 seconds going by. Here comes Tootie Zimmerman and the Holy Cross Crusaders. Trying to get across the timeline and do. Down into the corner goes Minetti. Zimmerman, Kolb, and they throw it away, but it's knocked out of bounds by Manning as the pass was intended for Kyle Murphy. Murphy looking for the inbounds, gets it to Minetti. Minetti just nearly has it taken away, but a nice no-look pass over to Trevor Platt, who puts it in. 4-0, Holy Cross. And away comes Vasquez. Across the midcourt line. Now over to Ireland on the left. Vasquez right, three on the way by Vasquez. No good. Battled for it, rebound taken away by the Crusaders. Long lead pass for Minetti. He's able to track it down, loses it momentarily, gets it back, trapped in the corner, gets it over to Cole. Tacked in away by Zimmerman. Nice save by Zimmerman in the corner. Minetti for his first three of the night. Rotation not there. And rebound taken down by Cole. Here's Kyle Murphy from the left side. No good. Rebound Ireland. Away come the Bulldogs. Ireland left side. He'll throw up a three. Top of the key. No good. Rebound. Tapped around. Manning has a hold of it. Now Cortez has it. Throws up. Rejected away by Cole. And lost out of bounds by Zimmerman.
Tough defense by the Crusaders right now.
Manning will inbound it. On the far side to Ireland. Here's Julio Vasquez on the right side. Now Ireland. No look pass inside. Malik Gray able to handle it. Now puts on a little show. Shake and bake, loses the ball inside. Just not a very disciplined move at all by Malik Gray. Out of control. He loses the ball out of bounds. Second turnover on the Crosby Bulldogs. With 2 minutes gone by here in the first. 4-0 Holy Cross.
Much like we saw last week, Crosby cannot buy a basket here early in the game. Just the same as against Sacred Heart a week ago.
Murphy right side underneath. All alone is Minetti underneath the basket. It's 6-0 Holy Cross. Great discipline and great offense to break the trap that Crosby has not yet shown, but Holy Cross anticipates it. Here's Ireland. Left-handed pass over to Vasquez in the corner. Long shot by Cortez, no good. Manning underneath, throws up a shot, no good. Rebound by Colby, loses it out of bounds. Crosby retains possession.
Crusaders offensively, they're coming up court and staying in the backcourt until 8 seconds or so are off of that 10-second violation before they penetrate, and all of a sudden they're looking underneath for layups.
Ireland from the top of the key can't get it to go down. Tapped up, no good by Gray. Tap up, rebound, put up and in by Cortez, and he's fouled. He'll go to the line.
So 2 minutes and 45 seconds off the clock before the Crosby Bulldogs finally get on the scoreboard.
Trevor Platt called with his first foul, first on the team. Cortez with the foul shot coming up. Takes his time, looks, gets a nice rotation on the ball off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound battled for, comes away with Mike Manning. Crosby retains it. From the side, Gray, no good. Murphy, the outlet pass now to Zimmerman across the midcourt line. Over to Cole, three ball on the way by Cole, in and out, and goes in. It counts. Ryan Cole with the three ball. 9-2, Holy Cross. Here's a three by Manning, no good. Gray, the rebound for Crosby. Three on the way by Vasquez, no good. Rebound underneath, taken by Cortez. Whistle, and he'll go to the foul line to shoot a pair.
Seven offensive rebounds already for the Bulldogs. Still only 2 points, nearly halfway through this first period.
Foul was called on Ryan Kolb, his first to second on the team. And here is Ricky Cortez to shoot the first of two. Off the back of the rim, no good. A little too heavy with the foul shot, and he's going strong with him. 4:43 remaining in the first period. It's a 7-point lead for Holy Cross at 9-2. Second shot on the way now by Cortez. And now there's a violation by Mike Manning. And it will not count. There will be no foul shot taken as Manning took off way early. And Holy Cross will inbound. Here's the inbound to Tootie Zimmerman. And he's picked up in the backcourt by Anthony Ireland. Token pressure by Ireland. And on the right side, Zimmerman calls out the play. Looks for Minetti. Here's Minetti. Gives on the handoff to Cole. Cole wants to come down the line, but instead 15-footer by Zimmerman. Good. 4 points on the night for Tootie. And it's an 11-2 lead for Holy Cross. Ireland to Cortez. Manning in the right corner. Back outside to Vasquez. Coming down the lane, throwing up a running one-hander. It's no good as he called him for a travel. Another turnover on the Bulldogs. That gives them three so far.
Last 2 weeks, Crosby just has not looked in sync. They have not looked like the same Crosby team we're used to seeing, but they're not the same Crosby team. There are a lot of newer players this year.
Ball taken away by the Bulldogs on the run. Here comes Ireland with the shake and bake move. Can't get it to go down. Tied up in the backcourt, Trevor Platt and Ricky Cortez. And the possession arrow belongs to the Crosby Bulldogs, and they'll inbound it. Malik Gray will inbound underneath his basket. Has Ireland. Jump stop inside, throws up a shot. He'll go to the line to shoot a pair. So Anthony Ireland will get a shot to shoot two. And Trevor Platt picks up his second personal foul. Third on the team. But Holy Cross leads it 11-2 with Ireland to shoot a pair. Make it 11-3 as he hits the first one, does Anthony Ireland.
Checking in the game for the Crusaders, Rashawn St. Just replacing Trevor Platt with his two personal fouls.
Second foul shot by Ireland is good. 11-4, Holy Cross leads. Murphy brings the ball, starts to bring the ball up court. Here comes Crosby pressing. Now they lay back, and Manning with two hands jumps right in on Murphy, but the timeout was called by Murphy. Manning jumped right in, grabbed elbows and everything. No foul. They're going to let him play. A week ago, we saw that type of foul called, Steve. So this week, they're going to let him play a little bit.
A little different style of play allowed by the officials this week than a week ago, as we had a lot of ticky-tack reach-in fouls. This time, Murphy almost got mugged and went down with the ball and had a Crosby player jump right on top of him. No foul called.
And he was Murphy able to call that timeout and preserve the possession for the Crusaders. 11-4, Holy Cross with the lead here in the first period with 3:43 remaining. I'm Bob Sagendorf along with Steve Gesick and Arthur Gordon Woods Jr. bringing you tonight's action, NVL action from the Crosby Palace as we approach 7:30 here on the East. So glad you joined us on WATR AM 1320 and WATR.com, wherever you might be listening to us across our great nation. Tony Zimmerman pressed by Ireland, comes down the lane, dishes off, throws it off to Minetti, no good. Rebound taken away by Wendell Vasquez. Snaps it ahead to Ricky Cortez, comes inside, jumps off to Ireland. Ireland turn around, 15-footer, no good. Tapped around by Malik Gray, tapped around in control by Ireland, comes into the lane, throws his body into Zimmerman, and a foul called on Zimmerman when all the action was initiated by Ireland, but the foul was called on Zimmerman, and that'll be his first, and that'll be the fourth on the team.
Four fouls against Holy Cross, and Crosby has been at the foul line for all four fouls as the first shot by Ireland falls off, no good.
And Crosby has yet to commit a personal foul. So Ireland gets that with a second, and he nails that one. 3 of 4 at the line for Anthony Ireland, and it's 11-5 lead for Holy Cross. St. Just working the right side. Gets trapped. Zimmerman lets the ball go out of bounds. Interestingly enough, we get a couple of replacements coming in now for Crosby as Marcus Robinson will come in for Malik Gray.
And I believe B.J. Klein also checking into the Crosby lineup.
You are correct, sir. Here's the inbounds. Holy Cross gets it. This is Kolb, and now a whistle underneath. And B.J. Klein gets called for a foul as he just gets in the game. So there's the first foul called against the Crosby Bulldogs. Now inside all alone is Kolb, and Murphy spots him. First field goal of the night for Colby as a three-pointer, but a first bunny for him with 5 points on the night. 13-5 in favor of Holy Cross. Ireland on the left side. Wants to go against the defense. Now in a 2-3 zone are the Crusaders. There is Julio Vasquez with the three ball. He bangs it down. 13-8. Now, scramble on the floor, but Zimmerman's able to get it away, and he loses the ball out of bounds. Intensity picking up by the Crosby defense, Steve Gesick.
A couple of good hits out there on that sequence as well by the Bulldogs defensively. A lot of activity out there, and no fouls being called. 13-8. Holy Cross with the lead, 2:23 to play in this first period.
Here's Crosby now. Klein gets it to Ireland, top of the key. Right side, Julio Vasquez for three again. No good. Gets, follows up his own shot. Bounce pass to Robinson. Goes in with a running one-hander. No good. Rebound taken away by Kyle Murphy. Cleans the boards. Cleans everybody away. Gives it off to Zimmerman across the timeline. Into the forecourt on the right side. Here is Murphy. Wants to throw up a three. Straight ahead three off the glass. No good. Rebound by Kolb. Goes down with the ball, and he'll be fouled. Foul on the floor. Let's see who it's called against.
Uncharacteristic shot that time by the Crusaders as Murphy kind of threw up that three pretty quick in that offensive sequence.
Anthony Ireland with his first personal foul. Second on the team. Crossed inbounds. 15-footer by Murphy, who gets fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot two. So just as we mentioned, Holy Cross had all the fouls. Crosby now catching up.
Three within the last 20 seconds as four of the three now in fouls. Murphy will be at the foul line to shoot the two. That foul was on Ricky Cortez.
First foul shot by Murphy is good. For Cortez, his first foul. Three on Crosby, so things have evened up. Julio Vasquez sits down to catch a breather. And into the game is Steve Dunbar. Second foul shot by Murphy is good. First 2 points of the night for Kyle, and it's a 15-8 lead. Now losing the ball is Dunbar. He didn't do that all football season, Steve.
No, he didn't. Just took his eyes off of it before he actually had the ball. Great look inside by Zimmerman.
And who got the basket, Minetti?
Over to Minetti.
Great job there, and 4 points for Minetti. 17-8 in favor of Holy Cross. As you see here, the student body of Holy Cross shouting for defense. Whistle and a blocking foul called. I believe that's going to be on Kyle Murphy. Now our officiating crew of Mike Scanlon, Gary Rispoli, and Bill Murphy decided they want to tighten things up a little bit.
And you're right, it was on Murphy, his first, fifth on the Holy Cross Crusaders in this period.
Klein and Manning back in. And now there's an offensive foul called on Ricky Cortez as he charged right into Kyle Murphy.
Great job by Murphy holding his position there, and Cortez lowered the shoulder. No doubt about that foul. Second on Cortez.
And he will immediately sit down. And Julio Vasquez comes in. Here's the inbounds. And Tootie Zimmerman has his hands on the ball. Picked up by Ireland. Over to Murphy on the right side. Now left side here to Zimmerman. Nowhere to go. Oh, nice spin move. And coming down the lane and putting it in. What a gorgeous move by Zimmerman on Ireland. He left Ireland just holding his socks. 19-8. Intercepted by Trevor Platt. And Ryan Cole, he pushes it up court. Here come the Crusaders. Zimmerman has the ball knocked out of his hands by Manning. Now, Minetti with a three on the way. Good. Bingo. For Minetti, his first three of the night.
Very quick 9-0 run by the Crusaders.
22-8. They lead with 30 seconds to go in the first period. Malik Gray with a bunny, no good. Away come the Crusaders. Clearing the boards was Kyle Murphy. Giving it off to Zimmerman, and they'll play for one shot. Generali puts one finger over his head. They want to play for one. Spreading the floor. Minetti has designs, but now sends it back to Zimmerman. Cross court it goes. The Kolb underneath with a reverse. That's good. Oh, a gorgeous pass play there by the Crusaders. And they take a commanding 24-8 lead at the buzzer. There goes a shot by Ireland. And Ireland, with all kinds of frustration, just throws his hands up in the air. Talk about being frustrated. The last 2 weeks, Steve, you and I have seen Anthony Ireland just being totally frustrated. We'll take a 60-second timeout. One period complete here at the Palace. It's Holy Cross 24, Crosby 8. You're listening to NBL Basketball on 1320 WATR.
Ladies and gentlemen, as a reminder, as you enter or exit the gymnasium, please utilize the sideline.
Back at the Crosby Palace, Bob Sagendorf's team gets it. Gordy Woods, second period action underway here with a commanding lead of 24-8 by Holy Cross, but Crosby's able to steal in the forecourt. Ireland driving to the basket and foul on the floor call. We'll see who this is up and coming against.
Looking at some of those first quarter stats, Crosby out-rebounding Holy Cross 12-6, including 10 offensive rebounds. But the Bulldogs, 1 of 13 shooting from two-point range.
Wow.
While Holy Cross, 8 out of 10.
Foul was called on Cliff Aquino. And the Holy Cross came away with the ball there, but a whistle and a foul. And that'll be coming up against Crosby.
Brian Kolb with another steal that time as just used his height advantage to come up with the interception on the pass and got the ball back for the Crusaders.
Julio Vasquez gets called for the personal foul. 5 now on Crosby. Inbounds taken away. And here comes Mike Manning. Gives it off to Ricky Cortez. 10-footer no good. Slams into Minetti. And that'll be another foul. That'll be 3 on Ricky Cortez.
The last foul they had on the board against Anthony Ireland.
Okay.
Which would be his second, so. But it is 3 fouls on Cortez. He did have 2 before in the first period.
So this is the second week in a row we've seen Crosby get into early foul trouble, Steve.
And they are in trouble right now with Cortez with 3 fouls with 7:28 to play here in this first half.
Murphy with a 15-footer from the side, way overshoots. Manning the rebound off to Ireland, who wants to push. Brings it up court against Zimmerman, goes to the basket, puts it up and in. Anthony Ireland with 5 points tonight, 24-10. Cross breaks the press. Now they lose the ball out of bounds to the Crusaders. 4 turnovers now against Holy Cross. 5 against 6 against the Bulldogs. Here's Ireland. Through the legs over to Vasquez. On the left side. Brings it back over right side to Ireland. Nice inside pass, but it went off the hands of Murphy. Great pass inside to Marcus Robinson, who just wasn't ready for it.
Anthony Ireland is ready to take this game over. You can just see it in his body movements and his facial expression.
Manning with a 3, no good. Tapped around. Zimmerman loses the ball out of bounds. Crosby retains possession. Minute gone by here in the second period. It's a 14-point lead for Holy Cross at 24-10. And once again, it's a kind of a mellow crowd again, Steve. You notice that? Last week it was. Packed house, but everybody's just kind of sitting around waiting.
Well, it's not the style of game that you're used to seeing these Crosby Bulldogs play. To be nearly or 9 minutes into a game and only have 10 points, that's not Bulldog basketball.
From the side, shot no good. Robinson, the rebound, takes it inside, can't get it to go down. Rebound taken away by Murphy, looking for help. Gives it off to Minetti, and away comes Holy Cross. Minetti with his head up, comes across the timeline, trapped into the, gets into the side. Holy Cross moving the ball around nicely, knocked out of bounds. Holy Cross now is facing that half-court trap by Crosby, but instead of taking it into the middle like Sacred Heart do, they're taking it down the side, and they're in trouble with it down the side.
They're having a lot of close calls. They did turn it over earlier this period on the sideline pass that went out of bounds. That time, Murphy nearly stepped out of bounds before getting the ball away.
Eric Albin into the game for Holy Cross. Here's Minetti, wants to launch a 3, lets it fly, in and out, rebound by Putty Zimmerman, who's able to put it in. 8 points for Zimmerman. 26-10. Holy Cross with the lead. Ireland with an over back. He carried the ball. Great call by the official there because he went 6 o'clock, 12 o'clock. Carried it over, and it's another turnover by Crosby. Zimmerman working against Ireland. Right in front of our broadcast position. Platt looking. They passed it into the middle. Here's Cole. Cole working into the middle. Gets over Platt. No good. thrown it away, and away comes Crosby on the move. Ireland going to the rack, can't get it to go down. Rebound pulled away by Platt. On the run comes Cody Zimmerman with numbers. Comes to the foul line, throws up a shot, no good. Minetti the rebound, he'll back it out and reset the offense, or will he? Yes, he will, throws it right over. Here is Cole from the side, no good. Rebound taken away, and away comes Julio Vasquez. On the run, comes right up the middle, comes right down the paint, throws up a running one-hander, no good. Rebound taken away by Platt. Platt for Holy Cross, gives it off to Zimmerman, who says, oh, let's put the brakes on here a minute, fellas. That was a little bit too much, up and down, helter-skelter. Let's settle things down. Now into the forecourt is Kolb on the right side. Gets it over to Platt, who's not ready for it. Second time down, that Platt has not been ready for the ball. Robinson throws it away. Minetti comes away with it. Minetti, two on one. Looks over and one nice no-look pass to Zimmerman, who puts it in. 28-10, and here comes Ireland back the other way. Going one against four, and there's a blocking foul that'll be called on Albin. Anthony Ireland trying to go one on four there is very lucky to get a foul.
He's trying to do too much by himself. And he's a very talented player, but he can't do it all by himself. He's got to get his teammates involved, whether it's dribble penetration, dishing it off, making some nice passes. He can't do it all by himself.
He's totally frustrated because he has no supporting cast with him, Steve. He really doesn't. In the past, he had BJ or he had LeVar, Lamar, and he has this is not a supporting cast for him right now. They're not doing their job. He misses that foul shot, does Ireland. And Tony Zimmerman has it. Zimmerman takes his time coming across the midcourt line. There's the trap. They get it to Kolb. Kolb gets slapped at, has it taken away by Julio Vasquez. Three on one. Vasquez goes to the hole, puts it up and in. And a whistle and a right after that basket, because Nick Augelli wants a timeout, and he is not happy with his team over there. Steve, when you look at Ireland, he's trying to do everything, as you said. He's got no support from anywhere. Take a look down at the scoring sheet.
Right. Ireland's been trying to do it all himself. He's getting very little help out there, and I don't know if there's some friction between the players or if it's just the style of play or if it's just talent that's lacking, or it's just not a typical Crosby unit out on the court.
28-12, Holy Cross leading Crosby here with 4:38 remaining in the first half of play. Bob Sagendorf along with Steve Gessick and Gordy Woods, Jake Crawford in the Music Museum back at the WATR studios. And a reminder that you'll be able to upload some of the highlights of this game probably in the next couple of days by going to birdseyesports.com and checking out the video section. Ben Talbot here tonight getting some good video. Coming up in the half, by the way, Steve will be talking to Tommy Riley of Bird's Eye Sports. Tommy goes around the state and probably sees more high school basketball games than anybody. Here's the travel. Now here is now a turnover by Kolb. And once again, the half-court trap by Crosby getting the ball back into the hands of the Bulldogs. A surprise that the Crusaders have not gotten into the center, Steve.
Well, Kolb was right in front of the Crosby bench, and he thought he got a timeout called and actually took a step. But it wasn't granted the timeout, turning the ball over. But again, like you said, they're going to the sidelines, and they didn't learn by watching the Sacred Heart game last week.
Manning misses a three. Holy Cross comes away with it on the rebound. Here is Zimmerman. There's a travel and another turnover, as into the game is Mike Mallory.
Mallory, only a freshman out there in a game against Crosby. Six games into his high school career, comes into a game against Crosby, makes an early turnover.
Dunbar inbounds it to Ireland. Crosby trying to fight back into this contact. They're down by 16 at 28-12 with 3:50 left in the first half. Ireland into the paint, elevates, throws up a shot, good. 7 points tonight for Anthony Ireland. And it's a 14-point lead right now for Holy Cross at 28. Here's a steal. No, Kolb gets it back. Kolb will throw up his shot. No good. Rebound underneath. Now Kolb will come in with the bunny and put it in. Nice feed underneath. And Kolb now with 9 points here tonight. 30-14 Holy Cross.
That feed was from the freshman Mallory. As a great offensive rebound and pass.
Dunbar leads it away. Lead pass for Mallory, who puts it up off the glass and in. Quick 4-0 spurt by Holy Cross extends it to 32-14. Their lead over Crosby. Here is Ireland. Ireland. Outside shot taken, a long three ball, no good. Taken there by Robinson. Away comes Holy Cross with the rebound. Kolb into the paint, dishes it off. On the right side, Alvin can't get it to go. In fouling up is Murphy, who puts it down. 4 points for Murphy. It's a 6-0 run right now for the Crusaders. Julio Vasquez with the shake and bake move, but he gets the foul. And coming up with the foul, we'll wait for the official call up on the board. I thought I saw a 33, but there's no 33 out there.
Maybe it was just three.
Three? Now, if so, that would be
they
against Mallory.
Still have it up. There it is, yep.
That's Mallory's first. First foul shot by Julio is good.
Eight personals now against Holy Cross. With 2:38 to play, Crosby with six fouls in this half.
34-15. 34-16 as Vasquez makes good on both. Zimmerman working against Ireland now. And they're waiting for the trap, and there's a pass to the center, but it's a bad pass by Zimmerman. Another turnover by the Crusaders. Vasquez launches, no good. Rebound underneath. Malik Gray loses it, but they say it was awful. Holy crosses Murphy. And Crosby retains possession. Interesting. So now inbounding will be Julio Vasquez. As he looks, and now finally gets it into Ireland. Outside it comes to Klein. Over on the right side, Robinson comes baseline, throws up a shot, no good, tries for it himself, can't get it, but recaptured by Klein, dishes it off underneath, whistle and the foul call. Malik Gray will head to the line to shoot a pair. He has not scored so far tonight. Cody Zimmerman picks up his second. And here's Gray. First foul shot underway. Good. First points of the night for Gray. And makes it a 34-17 Holy Cross lead. Gray gets ready with his second shot. And can't get that to go. Kolb the rebound. Gives it away to Minetti. And away comes Minetti with the bounce pass. Right over to Mallory. Yes, and it counts. And he'll go to the line.
Crusaders just out-hustling the Bulldogs right now.
Anthony Ireland just picked up his third foul. And Mallory goes to the line to try and complete the old-style three-point play. Can't get it to go. And Crosby the rebound. Here's Ireland. 2 minutes to go in the half. 36-17. Crosby down a bunch to Holy Cross. And the lead too far by Zimmerman. As Crosby had given up numbers to Holy Cross there, but the Crusaders threw it away. 36-17 with a minute 51 left in the first half of play.
Ireland heads to the bench for the Crosby Bulldogs now with his three personal fouls.
Here's Klein over to Vasquez. Vasquez back to Klein on the left. It goes over to Robinson, left side. Klein on the left, drifts to the middle. Dishes it off, loses it. Here's the pass away to Minetti, taken away by Vasquez. Behind the back, he keeps it, and now comes down the right side. Here's Klein with a three ball and makes it from the right side. B.J. Klein with the three ball, makes it 36-20. Holy Cross with a minute 18 left in the half. Cross court it goes to Murphy. Murphy loses the ball to Vasquez. Minetti was all alone, and Murphy decided he wanted to keep it. Now Vasquez into the forecourt. Gives it to Robinson with a jump step coming down the line. No good. Rebound by Robinson. Robinson goes back up. Rejected away by Murphy.
Rejected, but they're going to call a foul on Murphy on the play, as to the chagrin of the Holy Cross faithful, where the play was right in front of him.
Let me tell you something. If he connected with body, I want to see that again, because I saw nothing but a ball being swatted out of the air and no body contact. And now they just teed up. Did they just tee it up?
They had to tee up somebody as going to the line to shoot two foul shots with Vasquez, so it's probably a bench technical against the Crusaders.
Vasquez makes good on that foul shot.
Here's a chance for Crosby to make a run. They just had the three from B.J. Klein, and now a chance at four foul shots as Vasquez two for two from the line.
Murphy was called for the foul. And now here is a 36-22 game. Mike Manning with the shot, no good. Follows up his shot, it's good. So here come the Bulldogs making a run, 36-24. Holy Cross with the 12-point lead. It was up to 16.
It was up to 19,
right.
36-17, a 7-0 run right now for the Bulldogs.
Now taken away by the Bulldogs as they make their push. Coming up court, Robinson goes to the rack, can't get it to go down. Bodies flying everywhere. They're letting them play basketball. Zimmerman behind the back, puts it up off the glass, gets it to go down. And away comes Vasquez into the midcourt, 38-24. Vasquez coming down the line, puts it up off the glass, no good. Murphy the rebound, and away comes Zimmerman. That crowd's all hot now, and so are we. Here we come with some basketball. They go to Kolb underneath, backs it up, no good. Tapped around, Zimmerman the rebound, puts it up and in. Zimmerman with 13, 14 points as the half comes to an end. What a flurry at the end, ladies and gentlemen. 40-24, your halftime score. The Holy Cross Crusaders leading by 16 over the Crosby Bulldogs. We'll take a 2-minute break. And when we return, Steve Gesick will be talking with Tommy Riley from Bird's Eye Sports as they look at high school basketball in the NBL and around the state. Once again, your halftime score, Holy Cross 40, Crosby 24. You're listening to NBL Basketball on 1320 WATR.
He's got a lot of energy and he loves what he does, and he sees more basketball than the two of us combined during the year, and of course he travels all over the states and gets to see everybody. But going back to some of Gordy's stats, Crosby has to shoot better here in the second half if they want to get back into this game. 5 of 30 from two-point range, 2 of 16 from three-point range.
Wow.
The Bulldogs had a 12-6 rebounding edge in the first period. Holy Cross has now taken a 20-19 edge in reboundings in the game, with Kyle Murphy leading the way with 8 boards, 7 of them on the defensive end.
Yeah, Murphy's been very impressive tonight off the boards, hasn't he?
He has. He's got a wide body. He's a big force in there and uses his body very physically as clear some space for himself. Crosby cannot match up to the likes of Murphy and Kolb right now under the basket.
All right, so we're just getting ready for the crowd to settle down. We can play some basketball here. It amazes me, huh? Kids don't care. We're waiting for them to play basketball. We just had two students walk right through the officials and the basketball players. It's like, hello?
We still got Nick Augelli out on the on the floor talking with the officials as well on the other side of the court. And I think that's just because he realizes fans are still coming in and walking on past the baseline to get over to the other side of the stands.
And he and Eddie are laughing about it. So he's like, okay, here we go. Up now we're going to get some towels out here. A little bit of moisture, I guess. And we got some water spillage over there. That's what it was. That's what seems to be the problem. All right, now we're going to let some more people go by. And now we'll eventually get this third period underway. I guarantee it. As Dave Iaronimo, the athletic director here at Crosby, is doing some maintenance work right in front of the Crosby bench as some water got spilled. We saw some moisture problems last week down at Alumni Hall at Sacred Heart. And I think we're finally ready to go. Here we go. Ireland gets the ball. Aurelio Vasquez. Vasquez to Anthony Ireland. Ireland to Vasquez, off the glass, no good. Mike Manning taps it up and puts it in. Mike Manning with 4 points tonight. And it's 40-26. Holy Cross. Minetti with the no-look pass to Zimmerman, who goes up off the glass, can't get it to go down. Rebound taken away inside by Cole, rejected and taken away by Malik Gray. Here comes Crosby, pushing the ball up court. Vasquez goes underneath, and it was Cortez, and he'll be fouled, and he'll go to the line.
I believe it might be on Murphy. If it is, it would be his third.
And it was, and in fact, on Kyle Murphy, and it is, in fact, his third.
And again, if you happen to watch this game on public access television, you'll see Murphy gets called for the foul because he came down with his hand to block the shot.
First foul shot by Cortez is missed. He's 0 for 3 tonight at the line. His second foul shot is no good, 0 for 4, and Murphy with the rebound. It remains 40-26, Holy Cross. Just underway here in the third period of play. Bob Sagendorf, Steve Gesick, Gordy Woods on 1320 WHR Waterbury, Connecticut. Minetti now backs it out, gives it to Zimmerman, trapped. Now to Minetti, comes baseline. Minetti comes all the way in, throws up a running one-hander, no good. Rebound by Trevor Platt, throws it up off the glass, no good. Rebound taken away by Cortez. Cortez wants to push it up court, loses the ball. Zimmerman takes it away. Zimmerman, 2-on-2. Up to Murphy, who puts it up and in. Nice feed from Zimmerman to Murphy. 42-26, Holy Cross. Here's Julio Vasquez, and he's fouled by Tootie Zimmerman. That'll be his third. And an inbounds will be by Crosby underneath their own basket.
Zimmerman tried to reach around behind and slap the ball away. He got called for the reach in foul. So a couple of players for each team now with three personals. Be interesting to see which team can survive the foul situations.
There's the inbounds to Gray. Gray now backs it out to Vasquez. Ireland launches a three, bounces around the rim, no good. Vasquez gets the rebound. He thinks about shooting, now bounce passes to Ireland. Comes down the lane, floating one-hander, no good. Rebound by Vasquez. He'll throw up a three from the side, rough side, good. Julio Vasquez with 10 points. Makes it a 42-25 game, I guess that is, up there, 29. And then he calls for a 30-second timeout. Yeah, it's 29. And 42-29, as some of the lights on the scoreboard need some repair here at the Crosby Palace. So it's a 30-second timeout taken by Generali, Steve.
Second three of the night for Vasquez. It gives him 8 for the season now as Crosby not afraid to keep shooting from outside. That's part of their game. And even though they struggled 2 of 16 in the first half, they'll continue to throw up balls from beyond that arc.
So back out on the court come the teams. Trevor Platt, Cody Zimmerman, Kyle Murphy, Ryan Kolb, Rob Minetti for Holy Cross. Malik Gray, Anthony Ireland, Mike Manning, Steve Dunbar, and Julio Vasquez for Crosby.
Crosby extending the defense man-to-man into the backcourt on that inbounds play.
Minetti has it knocked out of his hands, out of bounds, and Cross retains possession. Generali said, hey, where's my call on those reach-ins? Zimmerman, the inbound, and now whistle and a foul. Malik Gray gets called with the foul. And that'll be his first, that's the way I have it. And now the inbounds by Holy Cross. To Murphy, all alone under the basket, connects. 6 points tonight. 8 points tonight, make that for Kyle Murphy. Dunbar, Ireland. Vasquez, three ball, no good. Rebound, Gray, underneath, good. Gray with the rebound right there has 3 points. 44-31, Holy Cross, the 13-point lead. 5:30 remaining in the third period. Zimmerman breaks the press. Now Murphy goes right to the basket and puts it in. Strong move by Kyle Murphy. But here comes Crosby pushing it up court. Manning wants to throw up a three. Good. Manning's starting to find the range. That they call it a two, though. 46-33, Holy Cross. Murphy, he'll launch a three, in and out. Rebound by Kolb, but he'll call him for coming over the top, and he gives like a smirk, like, yeah, right.
I think they call him for pushing off with his lower hand. Pushed the player out of the way and got called for it, so foul against Kolb, his second.
And inbounding. Steve Dunbar gives it over to B.J. Klein. Julio Vasquez on the right. Not listening to his coach as Nick Giorgelli said, get over here. Now they finally move the ball around, and Julio Vasquez throws the ball away. 12 turnovers called against Crosby tonight. 46-33, Holy Cross with the 13-point lead. Under 5 minutes to play in the third at 4:50. Right in the middle goes Trevor Platt. Minetti fires a three off the feed. Good. Rob Minetti puts home a three ball, his second of the night. 49-33, Holy Cross. Klein over to Vasquez. Here's Dunbar. He'll launch a three. No good. Rebound taken away by Zimmerman. Lead to Minetti. Minetti lets traffic go by. Puts it up off the glass and in. Rob Minetti with 12 points tonight. 51-33, Holy Cross. And across the midcourt line comes B.J. Klein to Julio Vasquez. Vasquez in the corner. Steve Dunbar stops, pops. Good. Dunbar with his first points of the night. 51-35, Holy Cross.
Right where we were at the end of the half, at the end of the first period. 16-point Holy Cross lead.
Zimmerman gets through traffic, backs it out, now waits for Minetti. Minetti looks for Zimmerman in the corner. Zimmerman throws up a three ball, no good. Rebound, Vasquez. On the run is Vasquez. Coming right down, goes to the rack, puts it in. Julio Vasquez with 12 points. For the 51-37, there's a pushing foul called against Malik Gray. That'll be his second. Anthony Ireland will check back into the game, replacing B.J. Klein. Kolb calls forces forward. Looks for an inbounds. He gets it to Murphy. Murphy now has to bring the ball up court as heavy pressure put on Cody Zimmerman. Now Kolb into the right side. Give and go. And there's a slide and a travel on Murphy.
Nice play by the Crusaders. Murphy just unable to come to a stop as his feet hit the floor. They just slid. Called for the travel. Crosby now with a chance, and Manning hits a basket to bring them a little bit closer, and will go to the line. No, they call an offensive foul against Manning.
So that will be, I have as his first. And the team's third. 51-37, Holy Cross. Zimmerman getting worked over by Ireland. Tries to go away, gets away from Ireland. Now comes across the midcourt line, gets it to Murphy, back to Zimmerman. Here's Minetti. Minetti at three ball range, but gives it up to Zimmerman. Cross trying to break the pressure. Zimmerman comes inside, loses the ball, battle for it, and away comes Kolb. Kolb now gives it to Minetti. He'll throw a three, good. Minetti's third three of the night, makes it 54-37, Holy Cross. Manning throws up a three from the left side, in and out. Rebound taken away by Kolb of Holy Cross. He'll be fouled in the backcourt by Anthony Ireland. Oh, no, they just lost the ball out of bounds. And Holy Cross will inbound. Trevor Platt gets it to Zimmerman on the inbound. Zimmerman picked up by Ireland. Across the midcourt line. Now here's on the right side, Minetti for a three, in and out. Rebound by Murphy. Murphy tied up by Ireland, and the possession arrow belongs over to Holy Cross, a little inbound. Minetti will inbound it underneath his basket. Slaps the ball, looks for someone to go to. Looking, looking, looking. Finally gets it to Zimmerman, three on the way. Good! Cody Zimmerman's first three of the night. 57-37, a 20-point lead. Here's Dunbar back the other way for a Crosby with a 15-footer that goes down. 57-39, Holy Cross with a commanding lead with 2 minutes remaining in the third period of play. Nice pick there by Trevor Platt to free Zimmerman. Running one-hander through the lane, no good. Minetti the rebound. Running one-hander through the lane is good. Rob Minetti with the field goal. 59-39. Vasquez comes into the paint, throws up a hook shot, no good. Rebound by Kyle Murphy. Tied up in the backcourt by Malik Gray, who commits his third foul. Three fouls on Malik Gray. Three fouls on Ricky Cortez. Three fouls on Anthony Ireland. That's Crosby side of the ledger. For Holy Cross, Tony Zimmerman, Kyle Murphy both have three.
Four fouls against Crosby now in the second half, three against the Crusaders. As Holy Cross just continues to lead this game by 20 points now, matches their largest lead of the game with the ball. Full court pressure from the Bulldogs.
This is Ireland picking up Zimmerman behind the back, coming across the midcourt line. Zimmerman now with the no look underneath to Minetti, who reverses, throws it off the backboard, no good. Basket hanging is Anthony Ireland, who puts it up and in. 9 points for Ireland, and Augelli calls for a timeout, a 30-second timeout, as he needs to talk to his squad. 59-41 in favor of the Holy Cross Crusaders, and a commanding performance, Steve.
Commanding indeed. As the press by the Bulldogs not really affecting Holy Cross and not creating a lot of turnovers. It's affecting them a little bit, but Holy Cross able to handle the full court man-to-man pressure.
Well, now even the official, the assistant coaches are talking him in Nick's huddle, and you know that usually doesn't happen. Usually Nick's the one doing all the talking. All right, now Crosby back out on the court. And here come the Crusaders. 1:24 left in the third. 59-41 Holy Cross. Boy, Steve, this is going to open up some eyes around the state, won't you think?
It sure is, as Crosby on their home court, down by 18 late in this third period. Game not over yet. They still have some time, but it would be a huge hill to overcome, trailing by 18 with 1:40 to play in the third.
And here's the inbound to Zimmerman, to Murphy. They lose the ball. Cortez to Ireland. Ireland goes up against Zimmerman, who gets called for his fourth foul. That'll be four on Zimmerman. And some time to get creative for Ed Generali over on the far sideline as he's walking back and forth, pacing. He's a little frustrated with that. And here's Anthony Ireland to shoot two. Misses the first. Anthony is 3 of 5. 3 of 6 at the line tonight. Make it 4 of 7. 59-42. Steve Dunbar sits down. Manning into the game for Crosby. Now Tootie Zimmerman gets the inbound pass from Murphy. Looking to get it up court. Here comes the pressure. They get it over. And thrown away right away by Cliff Aquino. And it's another turnover by the Holy Cross Crusaders. They had to beat.
Aquino thought he had a cutter going to the basket and just threw a pass underneath the hoop, and nobody was there for the Crusaders. So another turnover. Crosby with the ball back, trying to extend this 3-0 run.
Dunbar with a three, bangs it from the right side. Steve Dunbar with a three ball. 59-45. Holy Cross, but here comes Minetti with a running one-hander that goes down. Good. Now Crosby answers right back.
Ireland.
Anthony Ireland comes back with a field goal. 51-47. Murphy working against Dunbar. Kolb now travels with the ball. As the Crosby pressure, Augelli's decided to go with the full trapping press.
It's forcing the Crusaders, especially with Zimmerman out of the contest as he's leaving now, to get the ball into hands of larger people that aren't used to working the ball up court. Ryan Kolb that time called for steps as Crosby gets the ball back, down by 14.
Cortez on the left side, outside the arc, now comes inside. Got the give and go to Manning. They can't get it go down. Rebound taken away by Aquino. And here's Minetti. Minetti will get it to Kolb. Kolb gets it now across the midcourt line to Aquino. Aquino gives it to Kolb. Kolb strong to the hoop. Can't get it to go down. Gets his own rebound. Has it knocked out of his hands. He'll go to the line to shoot two. And we'll see who that's called on. And that is on Mike Manning, his second. And Kolb will go to the line. Kolb with 9 points in the game. Had 7 in the first period. He's been quiet since, Steve.
Yes, he's just been a force off the boards as for the Crusaders, but nothing in the book
Here's Tootie Zimmerman with 8 seconds to go in the period. A running one-hander, no good. Rebound taken away by Ireland. 4 seconds, 3 seconds, going up and pulling. Can't get it to go down, and the period comes to an end. Mike Manning was going to go up with a huge slam, and it came out of his hands, and he blew it. And the third period comes to an end. 60-second timeout. Through three, your score, Holy Cross 61, Crosby 47. You're listening to NBL Basketball on WATR. About to get underway, Steve Gesick. Holy Cross holding a 61-47 lead.
Crosby on a little bit of a run, 8-2 to end that third period, but still got a long way to come back.
Cortez to Dunbar, fires up a three from the right, no good. And away come the Crusaders. Mallory loses the ball, and it's off of Vasquez's foot, out of bounds. Great call right here along the sidelines by our officials tonight.
Crosby came up big that third period, 8 of 15 shooting from the floor, while Holy Cross 6 of 15. That from two-point range.
Mallory inside to Murphy. Murphy breaks it down and gets it to go home. 12 points for Murphy, 63-47. Holy Cross. Here's Ireland floating down the lane. He'll get the foul. Anthony Ireland just trying to do everything, Steve.
Yes, he's Tommy Razor said at halftime, you know, he's trying to do it all himself, and he doesn't have the supporting cast underneath. He doesn't have a B.J. Montero under the basket like he had last year.
And at the line is Ireland. Mallory picked up his second foul. Ireland misses the first foul shot. He'll get one more. Ireland with 12 points tonight came into tonight's action, averaging 25.4 points per game.
His lowest output of the season earlier this week, only 22 points.
Second foul shot is good by Ireland. B.J. Klein will replace Steve Dunbar. Minetti and Kolb on the bench for Holy Cross right now, getting some rest. Trevor Platt into the game. Here's Tootie Zimmerman, double-teamed in the backcourt. Can't get through it. And now good defense. Trevor Platt able to get it down, and there's a foul on Uliel Vasquez.
A lot more contact under the basket when they were going for the ball.
Really?
And Vasquez gets called for a little reach-in on that one.
So now the inbounds to Zimmerman, picked up by Ireland. Ireland puts the body on him. Now the trap coming along the side. Mallory with the bounce pass inside to Zimmerman. Lays it right off to Murphy beautifully. 14 points for Murphy. 65-48, Holy Cross.
Big second half for Kyle Murphy on the offensive end.
In the left corner, our view obscured by officials standing in the way. Crosby loses the ball out of bounds. Gives them 13 turnovers tonight to 18 for Holy Cross. 65-48, Cross leading with 6:59 remaining here in the contest. Minetti about to get double-teamed. He traveled as he dragged that foot along. And it's really surprising that Coach hasn't, Ed Generale hasn't made an adjustment on this inbound, Steve. Recognize, the kids recognize they're going to get trapped as soon as the ball comes inbound.
What's more surprising is he still has his jacket on. We're in the fourth period.
Here's the inbound. Uliel Vasquez throws up a three from the right side. No good. Trevor Platt gets the rebound, pulls it down, has his arm pulled by Vasquez, who just picks up his third. Ireland with three, Vasquez with three, Cortez with three, Gray with three for Crosby.
And seventh on the team, so Crusaders will be headed to the foul line to shoot 1-1.
And Trevor Platt, who has 2 points tonight, will shoot for first. A slow start here to the fourth period. Platt lets it fly, a high arcing shot, that's good. 66-48, Cross leading. And yeah, it is that quiet in here. Second foul shot by Platt is good. 67-48, Holy Cross. Here's Klein. Throws up a three, that's good. B.J. Klein from deep, his second three of the night. Mallory gets it to Zimmerman. Triple team to Mallory. Mallory across the midcourt line. All alone is Trevor Platt, who can't hold on to the ball underneath the basket.
Well, it was a little high for him. He went up, tried to get it, just could not pull it in, and another turnover. Crosby, though, still 16 points down, just where they were at the end of the first period. We're now under 6.5 minutes to play.
Leo Vasquez slips, but he's able to recover. Floor is slippery. Watching these players slipping all over the place here. Coming down the lane is Ireland. No call. They let him play on. It could have called an offensive. What an interception by Klein. Top of the key. Lets it fly. No good. Follows up his own shot. No good. Zimmerman able to pull it away. Just rip it away out of Anthony Ireland's grasp. Ireland will pick him up now. Here comes the trap. Over to Murphy. Murphy trapped along the left side, tries to fight through, and now timeout called by Generali as he recognized his player was trapped. It's a full 60-second timeout. We'll take a 30-second timeout along the line. 5:55 remaining in the contest. Your score, Holy Cross 67, Crosby 51. You're listening to NBL Basketball on 1320 WATR. 1320 WATR, Waterbury, Connecticut. 8:30 here in the East as you listen all over the country on WATR.com. 67-51, Steve Gusick, a pretty impressive outing so far by the Holy Cross Crusaders.
Very impressive outing, and just going back to Gordy's records here, the last time Holy Cross won on this court, February of 2002.
Wow. So back out on the court come the boys.
And that was in the 82-53 win. That was the last of the 19 wins and 20 meetings between the two schools by the Crusaders.
Inbounds goes to Murphy, gives it off to Zimmerman. Zimmerman with a step down the lane and good. Cody Zimmerman with 19 points makes it 69-51. But here's Ireland answering, throws it up off the glass, gets it to go down. Anthony Ireland with 15 points. Ryan Cole coming up the court, throws the ball, has the ball knocked out of his hands by Ireland. Ireland lays it up and in, and a timeout called by the officials, and we have an injury. Mike Manning down on the floor hurt. And it looks as though back in here at Crosby while you were away. Crosby putting some pressure on Holy Cross, but Cross able to get the ball into the midcourt and a foul called on Robinson. That'll be his first. And at the line will be Rob Minetti.
Yeah, Robinson just went for the steal on an inbounds pass and just grabbed the arm of Minetti. So Minetti at the line shooting 1-1, hits the first.
So Rob, first time at the foul line tonight for him.
Crusaders now drop everybody back into the backcourt. Minetti on the line by himself.
And he gets a shot to go down. 21 points for Minetti. 71-55. Cross with the lead.
Nope, the jacket is off.
Jacket just came off, I guess, huh? Here's Ireland trying to rotate the ball over to Cortez. Does so. No good. Vasquez make it. Ireland able to get the ball. Ireland comes down the lane. Throws up a running one-hander and an offensive foul called on Anthony Ireland. That'll be four on Anthony Ireland. Trevor Platt will inbound. 5:02 left in this game. 71-55, Holy Cross leading Crosby. Boy, there are some scrums going on in this game right now. Trevor Platt gets it to Murphy, to Zimmerman. They break the press. Zimmerman tries over on the right-hand side, double team. Heavy pressure, loses the ball though, to the Crusaders. They gave it over to Vasquez. Vasquez on the run. Vasquez gives it over to Klein. Klein gets it to go down, and a timeout called by Augelli. So B.J. Klein gets the field goal. Gives him five on the night. 71-57. Holy Cross with the lead as we're going to play Timeout after baskets, but you can only do that for so long, Steve.
You can only do that so long as Crosby just trying to edge back into this game. They're on a 6-2 run right now, trying to get back. They're down by 14. They need a couple more quick turnovers and some baskets off of those turnovers to get back into this contest.
Both teams just with full timeouts left, two each, says Gordy. 71-57 as they go into their huddle. Both teams, and Ed Generali has his jacket off. He's down on one knee talking with his team. Nick Augelli down on one knee talking with his team.
Cross basically took control of this game by scoring the last 11 points of the first period to open up a 24-8 lead. And it's been double digits ever since then. The Bulldogs have never been able to get within 10 points, actually never closer than 12. Since that 11-0 run to end the first period.
Well, Cross still in their huddle, and now finally break it and will come out. Out onto the floor. And they will inbound it. Trevor Platt to inbound for Holy Cross. Platt moving around, gives it to Zimmerman. Zimmerman waits, initiates contact. Platt gets it over to Cole, but throws it away. Just as Generali designed it, goes and throws it away. That makes 24 turnovers now by the Crusaders, Steve.
Well, I'm sure Ed Generali, even if Holy Cross holds on to win this, he'll have things to work on with his team. Not too pleased with those turnovers as a missed shot by Manning, rebound goes off a Crosby player out of bounds.
All right, so inbounding will be Trevor Platt. Let's see who sits down. Mike Manning sits down for Crosby. And Steve Dunbar into the game. Here's Zimmerman. Zimmerman wants to work against the pressure, gets across from the pressure, behind his back, now tries to escape, and now gets the timeout, but he retains possession. 4:17 left in this game. 71-57 in favor of Holy Cross. This is a nip and tuck, huh? Sort of game plan being played defensively and offensively.
It has been, as Zimmerman that time was trapped on the sideline, had nothing to do with the ball, and forced to call a timeout right in front of us.
Now, you get some, I think Trevor, I believe Ryan Kolb is being looked at by a medical person over on the far side. Getting examined. It's getting pretty rough out there. So both teams still in their huddle. Let's try and see if can't really tell from our vantage point, but as though a trainer was attending to his mouth, Steve.
Well, I'm sure he could have taken an elbow or, you know, banged into the head or shoulder or something, and maybe some blood, and then they have to make sure no blood before they let him back on the court.
Ryan Murphy right in front of us to inbound. Looking for Tootie Zimmerman, gets it to Aquino. Back to Murphy. Cross court to Minetti. Lines up a three, lets it fly, in and out, no good. Rebound tapped around and controlled by Crosby. Here is Cortez who lays it up and in. Don't know if you want to line up three, Steve.
Not typical Holy Cross. They like to go to that four-corner stall type offense at times, and here they are pushing it right to the hoop again, one on three.
And turnover, and away come the Bulldogs. Here's Ireland throwing up a three. No good. Trevor Platt pulls down the rebound. It's raked in the eye. No call. He fights away from it, and now finally gets it to Murphy. Murphy over to Tootie Zimmerman. Three on one. Zimmerman, foul, no call. Yes, they finally did call it. Trevor Platt got raked across the face. No call there. They were tying them all up inside. Really letting them play basketball here. Finally, B.J. Klein gets called for the foul. That'll be his second. And at the line will be Tootie Zimmerman. Zimmerman with 19 points tonight.
But typical Holy Cross, they would be going into a stall, run the clock. Offense right now looking for backdoor layups, and they haven't done it as Zimmerman misses the first. Zimmerman looking for 20 points for the fifth time in six games this season.
71-59 your score. Crosby, Holy Cross leading Crosby. Second foul shot by Zimmerman, no good. And here come the Bulldogs pushing up fast. Going to launch threes. Ooh, nearly a travel there by Klein, and they call a three-shot foul.
I believe it was Minetti with the foul.
On Minetti. Rob Minetti gets called for his first personal foul. Now Klein, first foul shot's good. To 60. The lead now down to 11 with 3:30 left in the game.
Last time it was this close was 1 minute left in the first period, 19-8.
Second foul shot is good. It was only a two-shot foul, not a three. It's a 10-point lead. It was up to 20. The lead now cut in half. Here's Zimmerman. Trapped. Gives it to Kolb. Kolb gives it to Murphy. Murphy, no look to Trevor Platt. Up off the glass, no good. Murphy there to get it to go down. Murphy's able to answer, but here comes Crosby back into the forecourt. Ireland coming down, throwing up a wild shot, no good. Kolb the rebound. Kolb tries to get away from the pressure. Does so. Throws it away. And now here comes Julio Vasquez. Throws up a shot, no good. Cortez right there. Throws up a shot, good. Cortez with the basket. 73-63, Zimmerman. Tries to get away from pressure. Gets it over to Platt. Platt now escapes the pressure right in front of us. Throws it over the top. Gets it to Zimmerman. Zimmerman with a no look inside. Gives it over to Kolb. Gets it to go down. Nice touch pass by Murphy. Taken away by Zimmerman. Zimmerman goes up off the glass. No good. Blocking foul called against B.J. Klein. That'll be Klein's third. 75-63, 12-point lead for Holy Cross. Zimmerman will go to shoot two, and he limps to the foul line. As Tootie Zimmerman, still stuck on 19 points, missed his last two foul shots. Gets that one.
Holy Cross will be shooting two shots the rest of the way as Crosby now with 11 personal fouls called in this second half.
76-63, 77-63. Holy Cross. Three on the way from Klein. No good. Rebound, Minetti for Holy Cross. Clears it away. Gives it over to Zimmerman. Throws it down court to Kolb. Kolb cross court to Minetti. Minetti gives it to Zimmerman. Plays down the court behind the no look pass behind the head over to Murphy, who's fouled on the play. That was highlight reel material there.
Highlight reel material, but he's being talked to by Ed Generali right now on the sidelines as sure Ed is telling him we really don't need some of this right now.
Murphy misses the first foul shot. He has 16 points tonight. Murphy steadies himself for the next shot. Misses that one. 77-63 with 2:20 left. Holy Cross leading. Here comes Ireland down the lane. Puts it up and in. Anthony Ireland and Augelli will call a timeout. We'll call a timeout as well. 60-second timeout for you. 2:14 left in the game. 77-65. Holy Cross leading. You're listening to NBL Basketball on WATR.
To play 77-65 lead for the Holy Cross Crusaders. They'll have the ball inbounding under their own basket. Crosby with a full court press trying to make things happen. Ball inbounded to Murphy in the corner. Pass up court, stolen by Cortez. Cortez to Vasquez, back outside. B.J. Klein. Three-point attempt, no good. Tip back up and in by Ireland. 77-67. Another timeout called by the Bulldogs. 1:56 to play in the game as Ireland. Gordy, what do you
ball
have for
went out
Ireland
of bounds.
Now?
No, the ball went out of bounds.
Out of bounds, no timeout. So crossed back in. It's another steal by the Bulldogs. Three ball on the way from Klein, no good. Ireland high up to get the rebound. He's stripped by Zimmerman. Down court to Minetti. He's going to be fouled as he goes in for a layup attempt at 1:45. Thought it could have been an intentional foul, but they're not going to call that.
32.
Fouls on B.J. Klein, his fourth. And Minetti will be heading to the foul line to shoot two for the Crusaders. Lead by 10. They've never trailed in this game. They took the lead early in the first period, led 24-8 after one, and looking to stay unbeaten at 6-0 on the season as Minetti hits his first to make it 78-67.
Steve, he's got 22 points.
Nice night for Rob Minetti, coming off of a 24-point effort in their win earlier this week. Second foul shot also good by Minetti, 79-67. Bulldogs quickly into the forecourt, Ireland. Cross-court pass underneath to Cortez. Baseline drive, no good. Another rebound for Kyle Murphy. Crusaders coming up, Minetti into the forecourt now, pulls the ball back outside, and he's going to be fouled. And it's just going to be a parade of foul shots, I believe, for the Crusaders the rest of the way.
Fouls on Vasquez, his third.
So Minetti, who just hit two foul shots, back at the foul line to shoot a couple of more, trying to match his earlier output of the week as he hits his first here, and that would be 23 points tonight. He had 24 in the game earlier this week. That was all 8 3-pointers in that game. This time he's had a variety of scoring as he hits another foul shot to make it 81-67. Long three by Ireland, no good. Rebound off to the Crusaders, and fouled in the backcourt will be Cole. So 120 to play, an 81-67 lead for the Crusaders. Looks like Holy Cross is going to continue unbeaten in this game, 6-0 now on the season, as going to the line now to shoot two will be Ryan Cole.
81.
Vasquez was called for that last foul as well, his fourth. Colts first gets the shooter roll on the first foul shot, so the Crusaders have now made 5 consecutive foul shots.
Colts has 12 points as of now.
And wholesale substitutions by the Crosby Bulldogs, as Nick Augelli basically conceding this game right now with 120 to play, down 82-67. Colts hits the second foul shot, and we're back to that 16-point margin that the Crusaders had at the end of the first period and most of this entire game. Bulldogs shot up, no good. Rebound tapped around, finally pulled down by Kolb underneath, and Crosby pulls off the press a little bit, but full court pass to Murphy, lays it up and in for another basket as we go under a minute to play. Kyle Murphy, big second half for the Crusaders,
18 points total.
And I believe 14 of those in the second half as another three, no good, and Murphy with another rebound. Also around 14 or 15 rebounds in this contest as the Crusaders walk the ball into the front court with 40 seconds to play. Timeout called by Ed Generali, I believe, just to clear his bench and get the remaining JVs in the contest. 39 seconds to play this game. In the book, another Holy Cross win. First one on the Crosby Palace court since the 2002 season, and a rather easy win for the Crusaders by 18 points right now.
If Sacred Heart wins their game tonight, this is going to set up a good game for Tuesday night.
And of course, Allie and Dave will have that game on our WATR radio as Crusaders just turned the ball over. And that will be another sellout crowd as two 6-0 teams, if the Hearts can win tonight, will be meeting to decide the early season lead in the NVL. Norman Finkel puts a shot up, no good. Marcus Robinson with the rebound is fouled as he heads to the hoop with 25 seconds to play. So if you plan on heading over to Holy Cross on Tuesday night for the Holy War, it's going to mean more than ever this year as both teams unbeaten at 6-0 going into that game possibly. Robinson's first foul shot is good. Trims the Holy Cross lead to 17 as a couple more substitutions coming in. Everybody that's suited for the varsity has now played for both teams in the contest tonight. Robinson looks, shoots off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound, battle for, and a foul is going to be called on the rebound.
It's going to be a one-and-one situation for the Bulldogs as foul was called against, I believe, Brian Kolaski of Holy Cross. TJ Pierce going to the line to shoot one-and-one for the Bulldogs. Pierce shot off the iron, no good. Rebound for Crosby. Shot put up and in off the glass by Randy Banks as 85-70. Under 10 seconds to play in the game. Another turnover forced by the Crosby Bulldogs. So with 9 seconds to play, they will have a chance to trim the lead a little bit more, but this was all Holy Cross tonight. Once again, good defense by the Crusaders, keeping the Bulldogs outside. Final shot at the buzzer by Cody Persky goes in and out. And that's it, our final score here. 80, Holy Cross Crusaders 85, Crosby 70. We'll give Gordy a couple minutes. So we'll take a 2-minute break and we'll come back after these 2 minutes to wrap up tonight's game.
Time that everyone has a safe journey home. Once again, tonight's final score, Holy Cross 85, Crosby 70. Hope to see you again real soon.
Yes, I'm back. Bob Sagendorf along with Steve Guessing and Gordy Woods. Steve, thanks very much. As you continue to cover for me this fall with everything going on. Interesting end to the game.
Well, it was all foul shots at the end as Crosby had nothing, no chance, but had to just keep fouling the Crusaders, put them at the line, and then finally just with about a minute and a half left, Nick Augelli threw up his hands, put his reserves in, and basically conceded the game at that point. But it was all Holy Cross the entire night. Scored the first 6 points of the game. Never trailed in the contest. The Bulldogs, as close as they got the rest of the way, was 5 at 13-8. And then it was an 11-0 run to end the first period. And the lead stayed between 10 and 20 points the entire last three periods of the game, as Holy Cross had the game well in hand.
And there were a few tense moments for Ed Generali. The jacket did come off tonight, and his team did commit, 28 turnovers, I believe.
A lot of turnovers and a few missed foul shots, but all in all, a good effort by the Crusaders as they were able to come to Crosby and come up a 85-70 winner. First time that they've won on this court since the 2002 season.
That's breaks quite a streak, doesn't it? I think he's just about ready to go. And we wait for Gordy to give us the final stats on the night. But it's a very, very impressive win for the Holy Cross Crusaders here at the Palace.
And not only the first time that they've come here and won, but not too many other schools can win on this court as well during the regular season.
That's
it's
right.
It's been a very tough place for any team to win, and we know from Holy Cross, from Gordy's stats, but it'd be interesting to see how many games in a row it had been for Crosby here on this home court. I believe Wilby may have won here a few years ago.
All right, let's get over to Gordy.
Okay, guys, thank you. Final score tonight, Holy Cross Crusaders 85 over to Crosby Bulldogs 70. Leading the way for Holy Cross, Rob Minetti with 25 points, followed by Tootie Zimmerman with 21. Kyle Murphy had 18, Ryan Culp 13, Trevor Platt had 4, and Mike Mallory had 4. Shooting for Holy Cross, first half 16 for 24, second half 12 for 27, for a night of 28 for 51, 55%. From the three-point goal line, they were 2 for 7 and 3 for 7, for a night of 5 for 12, 42%. From the foul line, they shot 2 for 3 and 14 for 16, for a night of 16 for 19, 84%. For the 70 points for the Crosby Bulldogs, they were led by Anthony Ireland with 21 points, followed by Mike Manning with 6, Julio Vasquez had 14, Ricky Cortez had 6, Malik Gray 3, Marcus Robinson 1, B.J. Klein had 10, and Randy Banks had 2. Shooting for Crosby, first half, 5 for 30. Second half, 16 for 32 for a night of 21 for 62, 34%. From the three-point goal line, they were 2 for 16 and 3 for 20 for a night of 5 for 36, 14%. From the foul line, they were 8 for 14 and 5 for 11 for a night of 13 for 25, 52%. Score by periods. Holy Cross outscored Crosby 24-8 in the first quarter. In the second quarter, both teams scored 16 points to keep the same 16-point margin in Crosby and Holy Cross's favor, 40-24. In the third quarter, Crosby scored 23 points to Holy Cross's 21 to cut the margin to 14 points, 61-47. In the last quarter, Holy Cross scored 24 points to Crosby's 23 and be victorious by 15 points, 85-70. With the victory, Holy Cross improves their league and overall record to 6-0. They are 2-0 in the city. While the Crosby Bulldogs dropped to 4-2 in the league and overall, they are 1-2 in the city. In the first game tonight, the JV game, Crosby won the JV game 79-71. The JVs and Crosby are 6-0, while the Holy Cross JVs are now 5-1. With the victory for Larry DeVito's team, he has now 42 straight wins for his JV team. Now back to Bob and Steve.
Great job, Gordy. Thanks very much. So very impressive run by Larry DeVito and the Crosby JVs, but for the Crosby varsity, Steve Gesick, it's going to be a long year for these guys. They're not used to this.
They're not used to having two losses late in the season, let alone in the first six games of the season. There's 4-2 early in the season. And we're, well, almost a third of the way into the season already. They've got some work to do to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the state championship game again this season.
Well, Steve, coming up Tuesday night, we look ahead. Our WATR broadcast schedule will feature undefeated Sacred Heart against undefeated Holy Cross up in the big pit at Holy Cross High School.
And that should be a whale of a ball game there. As well, earlier this week we saw the Kennedy girls go into the pit and knock off Holy Cross girls to end an 86-game NVL winning streak. Could both teams suffer losses at home to end streaks within a week of each other?
It will be interesting. Dave Grant and Ali Vestro will have the call along with Gordy on Tuesday night. All right, partner. Good job. I'll see you next week when we bring another WATR game next Friday night. We'll be back, Steve and I. Well, maybe I will. I hope I will. Steve and I will be back as we're actually changing up. We're going girls next Friday night, and we're anticipating going girls Kennedy and Torrington. That should be a key girls matchup in the NVL. That'll do it for tonight's ball game. It has been brought to you in part by your local